Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. And today I want to answer a question that I get asked on a regular basis. I just need to persist a simple list of strings. Do I really need to create an additional entity for it? Well, it's better to map each string to an entity because it provides the best performance. But you don't have to do it if ease of use is more important than performance. Since JPA 2.0, you can use an element collection to persist a collection of value types. You just need to annotate the attribute with ElementCollection, and the persistence provider will persist the elements of the collection in an additional database table. But before we take a look at an example, let's talk about the drawbacks of this approach. The element collection might seem easier to use than an entity with a one-to-many association. But Hibernate can't handle an element collection as efficiently as an association. That's because the elements have no ID, and Hibernate can't address them individually. When you add a new object to the list or remove an existing one, Hibernate deletes all elements and inserts a new record for each item in the list. You will see that in more detail in the following example. Here you can see a simple author entity with a list of phone numbers. I just need to persist the phone number as a string and decided to map it as an element collection. As you can see, the mapping is a lot simpler than creating a phone number entity with a one-to-many association. But Hibernate handles the elements of the collection very inefficient. Here is a simple test case which demonstrates the problem. It selects an author entity and adds a second phone number to the element collection. Hibernate performs two select statements to read the author entity and the associated phone numbers. That's not ideal, but also not the main problem. It gets worse when I add the second phone number to the element collection. Hibernate updates the author entity, drops all associated phone numbers, and inserts a new record for each phone number. If I had used an additional entity and a one-to-many association, Hibernate would have created only one SQL insert statement. So an element collection is an easy, but not the most efficient option to store a list of value types in the database. You should therefore only use it for very small collections so that Hibernate doesn't perform too many SQL statements. In all other cases, a one-to-many association is the better approach. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!